Welcome to Unblocking the Blockchain. My name is Jonathan. Today we are going to talk about how to mint an NFT on Ethereum. First off, it is going to be slightly different depending on which project. Everybody has a slightly different site, but Ethereum is pretty straightforward. For our example, we're going to be using a project called the Giraffe Tower. Most NFT Discord servers have a channel called official links. In the Giraffe Tower official links, you could find the minting site. It's the first one. I would never click on any links that are not in this official links tab on these Discords, and always use your best judgment whenever you're doing that, because anybody could be posting a link that could lead to a malicious site. So we're going to go to the minting site right here at drafttowernft.com. You could also look at the contract over at Etherscan by just searching for the wallet, or in this case, they have it listed in their official links. This is the minting site for Giraffe Tower. This is an Ethereum-based project, so we have an Ethereum wallet. I'm using MetaMask. Most of these sites will have a spot where you could just connect your wallet. Click connect. Then it's going to have you verify which wallet you're logging in with and click next. Always verify that that is the correct address that you're trying to log into, and then connect to the site. And now your wallet is connected to the minting site. And this part's going to be a little bit different depending on the project that you are minting. In this case, you can mint up to 20 per transaction, but some only allow a certain amount, maybe 3 per wallet, or a smaller amount, or even a bigger amount per transaction. And down below here, it says how much each mint costs. The mint is basically creating the NFT. It's the first time it appears on the blockchain. So it costs 0.05 to mint one plus gas. And gas is the transaction fee. And that varies depending on how busy the network is. If you want to check the current gas price on Ethereum, you can go to etherscan.io and you could check right here. It says 27 Gwei is the current gas price. And that fluctuates throughout the day depending on how busy the network is. So you're going to enter in how many NFTs you want to mint. In this situation, I'm just going to go for the full amount and mint 20. And you could do whichever amount you want and hit mint. Since I'm doing 20 in this example, it's going to cost me one ETH, but it's only costing 0.05 ETH per NFT that I am minting. If you have enough money for the current gas price, you could mint it right away, or you could wait until the gas price goes down by clicking edit and then clicking advanced options and then saying what gas price you are willing to pay. I find that in the middle of my night, the gas price goes down. So if I said that I would be willing to pay maybe 17 Gwei, I could say save. And then I could just confirm, and that will only go through once it reaches that particular gas price. So I'm going to go ahead and hit confirm. If I wanted to check that transaction's progress, I can just go to the contract address, which is available in most of the official links for these Discord servers. And there it is. It is pending 40 seconds ago. I'm spending one ETH, and I said that I would be willing to pay 17 Gwei in order to do that. And now we just wait for it to go through, or we could adjust the gas price to a higher fee if we wanted to go through faster. All right, so the minting has gone through. And since I waited for the gas price to go down, it took 2 hours and 35 minutes for the transaction to go through. If I wanted to pay at the current gas price, it would have gone faster. And you can see all the token numbers that I got from that. And if I decided that I wanted to just do one, it would just be one token or however many that I actually minted. But looking on Etherscan, you could verify that those NFTs have landed in your wallet. And if I go to OpenSea and connect my MetaMask wallet, I can view all the compatible NFTs. These are all the NFTs that I just minted. And just a reminder, all the minting sites might be slightly different. But most Ethereum-based projects are following a similar pattern, but please do your own research. I don't give any financial advice, so please always do your own research. If you got value out of this video, be sure that you watch one of these videos next. And if you have any requests for future videos, make sure that you drop them in the comments. And be sure to like, subscribe, and ring the bell, and I will see you in the next one.